This movie has been an absolute joy to work in. I mean, it's quite typical. I think for most films, we say, oh, we had so much fun. It was this movie. I mean, swear to God, it is. I really didn't realize when it finished and when I was done with it, because it was a very nice setup. You know, the whole team and the location that we were shooting in. Most of my work was in Kollam, and it was based in this college, and. I didn't have much of a college life, you know, because I started acting very early, and it was a very nice, pleasant experience. Regarding Mamukka, yeah, this is the third time I'm working with him, and there is not a single time I've not been slightly awestruck or wowed by his presence on the set, you know, and he's constantly, I don't know, improvising, reinventing, doing these new things. So I'm all the time like very alert. I want to learn whatever I can for that time. And it was a huge honor and privilege to, you know, get a chance to share screen space with him again. Our director, Ajay Vasudevan, you know, already coming from having given a very big hit, and there was a lot of hype and expectations from this movie even before we started shooting. You know, when the offer came to me, and like I got to know what a big, there's already so much expectation from this movie, and it was just amazing to shoot, because I have, this was a very sweet character, but then again, I haven't played a college professor before. So, so far between my Tamil, Malayalam, Telugu films, whatever I've done, the max that I've done any college related thing was playing a college student, or they said you're the professor here, and you know, it's a very loved professor in the college, the students, very popular with the students, popular with the teachers, and I was looking forward to doing that, and I was very happy. First day they did my introduction, this very, very, very poetic, nice, beautiful shots that they did, you know, 48 frames of my, the typical, very, the slight filmy style, it's all slow motion with the sari flowing, and I loved the character, and I loved working in this film, and it was an absolute pleasure work. This was, honestly, I didn't, you know, I had very few combination scenes with them, except for what we shot towards the end. And last couple of days of the shooting, I think, is when I interacted with them for the first time. I not even interacted, it was more of just hi and bye after the pack up. But I think each artist brings their energy to the set. And when you have so many of these, as it is set in a college, you have all these students who are there as part of the movie. And then we had these very young actors, you know. So there was a lot of energy on the set. There was a very youthful vibe on the set, and it was just a pleasure to be there on the set. The first movie I still remember the first day I had to shoot with him. This was comparatively much easier, because I'm just a little lesser intimidated by him now. Not that I'm not, it's not like it's down to zero and I'm so free and comfortable, but it's just little more comfortable now. The first film, I remember before every shot I would have palpitation, you know, before you say the dialogue, because I had heard so much about him, and then there was so much of an image of his in my head, and then I knew he's won national awards and this and that, and I had the biggest dialogues in the first movie that I worked with him. So I was very conscious, how is my Malayalam coming across? I know it's not how it's supposed to come, but it was a little daunting for me, first film. Second film got better, because second Venice La Vyapari, I also had Kavya Madhavan with me, and one more bonding person you can bond with, one comforting factor was there. So then that got better, and then he's actually very cool to work with. There's this image of his that was there in my head, but once I started working with him, it's very easy to work with him. He makes the other actor's job much easier, and it just works very well. I don't know. I think each actor has their own method. When I come on the set, I come with a blank slate. Unless the director has asked me to do some special homework for it. You know, something, let's say it was a character which is very different from what I am really. Like, I have to get different body language and different expressions and different, all of those things. That would require some amount of homework, research and all. This movie, I just completely took Ajay's instruction for what he wanted. So, with that first day I came, he said, this is what it is. I need you to be like this. And yeah, you just smile and you do this, and this is how the students will react. So, it just went off in a flow. And although it was, I have not played a professor before and I was playing one here, but I didn't find it very difficult or out of my comfort zone, or, you know, it kind of just came very naturally when I played this character. He's like by far, I think, one of the coolest directors I worked with. He's so unperturbed. There are pressures during shooting and there are deadlines and there are so many things happening and so much of coordination. That too with so many students, and it's not an easy task. But he is very composed. Very composed, very sure of what he wants, and always smiling. So it's easy, you know, if that's how the director is, that's how his disposition is. By default, you kind of start reflecting that. So it was very easy to work with him. I can't pinpoint any one person. Like most of the time, see, initial few days, it would just be bit. I would finish my shot and just go, you know, sit with my phone or Kindle or typically what we just disconnect and then go back in. More towards the end of the film, the whole team is together. Between shots, so someone's birthday, we're cutting a cake, or there is just, it's a beautiful sunset, we're having a tea together while they're setting the next shot. So yeah, there were these moments where, you know, the whole team would be together. Varu would be there, the other lot of actors, all of them playing cops, and then students and everybody. We would all just maybe be sitting under a tree waiting for the next shot, chilling together. Yeah. I don't know, I think there was some bigger plan. We tend to make our own plans, and then I think destiny just guides you elsewhere, because my whole family had more of an armed forces background. Dad from the Navy, grandfather from the Navy, dad's father from the Army, uncle. So it was all that. No one, there was no one really remotely related to the film industry. So when it came to me and started, you know, after college, just around, actually before college, during the vacation, after your board's the vacation, that's when I got my first movie offer. So I remember how skeptical, because we hear so many things. And then yeah, there was a little, fortunately my parents are very broad-minded, you know, so there was no permission issue or like, no, we are not sending our girl to movies or anything like that. So I got in without really knowing how serious it's going to get. It just seemed like a very nice way to earn good pocket money, not study anymore, because I knew I can't do the regular engineering or MBA, or I just didn't have the chip in me. So thankfully, I think somewhere God answered my prayer, because I said I can't do an office 9-to-5 job. It has to be something creative, something which has a lot of expression, and so it started with that. And funnily, yeah, from the day that I've started movies, they've told me you look very native, very South Indian. And I've always had a soft corner for the South. We have travelled here a lot. I was born in Vishakhapatnam, and my mom's a South Indian. So there was just anyways a good feeling about it. And I used to see what craze the actors in the South have. You know, I mean, I sometimes think it's more than what is there in Bollywood. So I had a good picture about the industry, and it's been a wonderful journey. I mean, if I had to go back and change something, I would not change anything at all. They had content, and I worked with the biggest stars here in Malayalam, which didn't happen so easily elsewhere in the other industries. And then again, with those big actors, I had very good roles. You know, it had a lot of content, or they were author-backed, or they had something. It wasn't the regular song, dance, two romance scenes and one emotional scene, and I think I had to mold myself to the most subtle style of acting. No extra drama or no extra anything. It is the absolute, very, very natural, realistic way how you would react to something is what they want for the movie. So yeah, that was, I had to unlearn whatever acting I knew. I thought I knew acting. And then I realized that the lesser I do, that translates better on screen. So yeah, I learned some of my best things after coming into the industry, and I was treated like it felt like home for some reason. I received a lot of love, and everyone's been very warm. There is a lot, I don't know, I can't think of one thing. Maybe I can write a book on it, and I love guiding, you know, when I meet girls who want to, because there's so much of duality in the head. They've heard so many not nice things about the industry, nice things also. They want to also do it. They're not sure if it's safe. But regarding the South industry, I mean, it's been like family to me. It's something which will always be very special to me, no matter where I go from here. That stays, because it's just been very, very, how do I put it in? You get so much of love. It's not only when you become a star or only when you become somebody big. Even as a newcomer, the kind of, you know, respect you're given, love that you're given, it's, end of the day, I feel it's like any other job. And I think the one tip I would want to give is, movies per se, not really in the South or in Hindi or in Hollywood, but generally the film line or the anything related to media, it's a little different from a regular job. So, this industry, I think sometimes there are times where, you know, girls especially who are very young, the insecurities can get to them quite easily. And all I would want to tell them is, you know, make sure your base is strong, that your family ties are strong, that you have your friends from school who knew you before you became somebody famous, who knew you before you came on TV. You'll have those few friends. They don't really treat you any different because you've become somebody. Stick on to them, like keep them close to you, like, because they are your grounding factor. You need that people who talk to you like you're normal, just like you. That's very, very important. Because you can get swayed easily. That's the only tip I would like to give. I personally believe that one job that I know little bit about, let me stick with it and become like really good at it. Because the technical or the other part of it is, I find it quite tough. Film making as such. You know, director's job or the DOP's job or the editor's job, the musicians, the re-recording. I find it very difficult. I still sometimes feel acting is like the easiest part. And I'm quite happy sticking to this. Gut feeling slash intuition slash, it's 3-4 things. Lot of things, there's no fixed formula really. I mean, I'm a relatively impulsive person. There's not much planning to what I do next. And I wouldn't say I'm the most ambitious person. I've never had this, I have to be this number one right there. It's not been there. It's work has been coming, you know, on a consistent basis. I've finished these many years in the industry. I've got to play some wonderful roles. And I've managed to do this very, very happily, you know, without any kind of stress or making it too difficult for myself. Hi, this is Poonam Bajwa, and I would like to wish all the viewers a very Merry Christmas.